What a blessing it is to share with you what God is doing in Romania. Let me share with you our most recent project that the Lord has laid very heavy upon our hearts. In Acts chapter 2, we're told that those who gladly received His word were baptized, and the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls. And then we're told later, after He's described the church, that the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. We're also told in Matthew chapter 16, verse 18, that I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. We're so thankful to the Lord that He is building His church among the Gypsies of Romania. And we're so thankful to the Lord for you, each and every one of you, and your faithful prayers, your words of encouragement, and your sacrificial gifts. We thank the Lord for what He is doing and what He continues to do. Let me share with you a little bit about the background of the project that the Lord has laid upon our hearts. It began on January 1st, 2008. On New Year's Day of 2008, we celebrated a historical highlight in our church in Oșurhei. We ordained our first deacon, Iosif Teglaș. The Lord was testing Iosif through many trials during that time, including the death of one of his sons. Through it all, we were amazed by his testimony when he stated publicly that though we have trials, the Lord remains good all the time. God was raising up national leadership. It was at that service that we prayed for God's blessing and fruit to be displayed through the church in Oșurhei. Part of that prayer was answered through two events. First, we had a week of revival services in our church at the end of February. On the last evening, our guest speaker was Evangelist Walter Stevens. Following his powerful message, an invitation to come to Christ was given. Amazingly, several came forward for salvation from the village of Martihaz. They had been visiting family members who were members of our church. The second event which occurred began immediately. That weekend, our oldest church member and a four-month-old baby went home to be with the Lord. Both of these funerals brought a tremendous amount of grief among the people, but it also providentially caused the family members from the village of Martihaz to stay in Oșurhei for another week to support those who were grieving. The new believers from Martihaz asked significant spiritual questions that week. They were hungry to know more. When they left, they asked to be baptized and requested us to visit them as soon as possible. In addition, during those discussions, we found out that three other believers who had been baptized in Oșurhei during our previous term had moved to Martihaz and were praying for someone to come teach them. They had no pastor, no church, and no teaching there. After a few weeks of repeated requests, we sought the Lord in prayer for wisdom and direction. The result was that we decided, along with Iosif and several men from Oșurhei, to visit the village and to have a service. Following that service, eight more came to Christ for salvation. During the dinner following the service, the discussion centered around statements like, "We want to grow. We are so weak. We want to know Christ more. We want to understand the Bible. We have no one to teach us, and we have no church or pastor here." They asked if we would come once a week to have a service and to teach them the Word of God. It was not our intention to begin a new church plant, but we sensed that the Lord had a plan for these baby sheep and for the church in Oșurhei. We sought the Lord and His will and concluded that we would commit ourselves to a service on Saturdays each week. The church in Oșurhei became the mother church to this new work, and Brother Iosif took on a significant role of leadership to encourage this little flock of believers. In the months that followed, a few others came to Christ, and they began to grow. What an exciting time it was on July 26, 2008, when we announced the birth of this new church plant by way of their first baptism. It was held in the backyard of one of the new church members in a swimming pool. There were nine believers baptized that day, and four more were added to the church by testimony. Since that time, two others have been baptized. So this new little work has started with 15 church members. A group from our home church, the First Baptist Church of Mishawaka, Indiana, was with us to witness this historic occasion. This group of 17, along with members from our church in Osherhay, assisted with the service and the preparations for the day. The youth pastor from our home church, Pastor Pete Jones, preached and assisted me with the baptism itself.
Being a part of the group that went to Romania was an excellent experience for me. When we went into Martihaz and we went to the home where the baptism was going to be held, the host family, the wife, she took us into the house. As she did that, she took us into a room that they were hoping to use for the church building. And it was so exciting to see the smile on her face as she explained to us the joy of using their house for the church. We went outside and the first thing that happened was the individuals who were getting baptized gave their testimonies. And to see their faces as they gave their testimony and see the sincerity, even though it was being translated for me, I really didn't need to hear the words. I could see the sincerity in their face of their love for God and their desire to serve Him. After that, we had the baptismal, and I helped Pastor Tim as we lowered them into the wading pool and lifted them back up again. And it was so exciting to bring them back up and see the smile on their face, a genuine smile of knowing that they were now saying they were part of a body of Christ. And after we brought them back up again, the whole church would sing a song of praise to God. And again, I didn't know the words, didn't know what was being said, but it was a celebration of a new beginning, not just for that individual, but for the whole community. And it was exciting to see the thrill on their face. After the service, we had an opportunity to have fellowship time with them, and they made a meal for us. And they were so excited to be able to serve us this meal and out of what little resources they had. And one of the things that I really took away from that day was what we saw there was a group of believers who really loved God, had a desire to serve God, and were already what we think of and what we know of from the Word of God as a New Testament church. The home, the church building that they are looking to get is just an addition to making them a complete body of Christ.